Good evening. On behalf of Kennedy Center Chairman David Rubenstein and Kennedy Center President Michael Kaiser, it is my great pleasure to welcome you all to this evening's Millennium Stage performance. Every night of the year at 6 p.m., we present a free performance with the ongoing support of the Target Corporation. And when you're not able to be here with us in person, we invite you to join us online where we broadcast each night's performance, as well as making past performances available in our searchable archive. So again, welcome to all of you in the audience here tonight. Welcome to all of you who are joining us online from Washington, D.C. to Kabul. And welcome to the staff and students of this extraordinary orchestra, and also to the members of the Maryland Classic Youth Orchestra, who are playing an invaluable supporting role in tonight's performance. We are caught in an inescapable network of mutuality tied in a single garment of destiny. Whatever affects one directly affects us all indirectly. Less than 1 month ago, we gathered in this hall to celebrate the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who spoke these words. Among Dr. King's leadership attributes is that he gave a face and a voice to the aspirational ideals of a nation. Today, we gather again in this hall to celebrate a group of young musicians who share that noble distinction of leading by giving a face and a voice to the aspirations of a nation. In a time when so many powerful circumstances divide us, it is critical to celebrate what unites us. So let us consider two of the many things that unite us today. First, our belief in the power of music as a global language that helps us communicate across geographic and cultural divides. Second, and more importantly, is our belief in the power of our youth to leave this place, this world, better than they found it. Now, it is my privilege to introduce to you the Ambassador Extraordinary and Plenipotentiary of the Islamic Republic of Afghanistan to the United States, Ekleel Hakimi. And to our partner from the U.S. Department of State, Deputy Secretary William J. Burns.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you so much. I'm very pleased to be here at the Kennedy Center with my friend, Ambassador Hakimi, to welcome all of the musicians and teachers of the Afghan National Institute of Music to Washington. Let me also welcome the Maryland Classic Youth Orchestras joining their counterparts from Afghanistan on stage this evening, as well as Afghanistan's Deputy Minister of Education and the many distinguished guests and friends of Afghanistan who are with us here tonight. President Kennedy, for whom this National Cultural Center is named, was a lifelong supporter and staunch advocate of the arts, which he called our contribution to the human spirit. The ensembles of the Afghan National Institute of Music are a shining example of how the arts can lift and give hope to the human spirit. Afghanistan's rich musical traditions were once silenced by war and Taliban rule. But when democracy returned to Afghanistan, Dr. Ahmed Sarmast, who had left his homeland because of the violence, saw a chance to bring that tradition back to his country, founding what is today Afghanistan's Soul Music Academy. With the support of donors from around the globe, Dr. Sarmast invited children from all over Afghanistan and from all walks of life to study not just Afghan music, but that of world-renowned composers like Vivaldi and Ravel, and yes, even Duke Ellington. Dr. Sarmast did not just bring instruments back to life, he restored hope for a future where Afghans celebrate their rich, diverse cultural heritage and through that, restore their national pride and unity. As a partner in this endeavor, tonight's conductor, William Harvey, has spent the past 3 years in Kabul training this talented group of young people. Mr. Harvey and his fellow teachers have forged connections across cultural and national barriers in over a dozen countries throughout the world, including the United States. They've been a powerful force in defining the United States to the people of Afghanistan and beyond, for which we are truly grateful. As Secretary Kerry told these wonderful musicians earlier this week, the Department of State and the people of the United States are proud to sponsor the Afghan National Institute of Music as it continues this tour of Washington, New York, and Boston. We wish you great success, and may your tour and this experience strengthen the bonds of friendship between the peoples of the United States and Afghanistan. And now it's my great pleasure to introduce Ambassador Hakimi. Thank you.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I'm so delighted to be part of such a distinguished gathering in this historic event. And I would like to thank Deputy Secretary Burns and also our Deputy Minister of Education, Mr. Nang, and also the President of Afghanistan National Institute for Music, Dr. Sarmast, our Afghan community, and also friends of Afghanistan, and all that they have enjoyed us tonight. We are grateful for joining us to support ANIM. And ANIM's success illustrates the remarkable progress occurring in Afghanistan, particularly in our education sector. And it shows that the amazing talent can come from Afghanistan's young men and women when giving the right opportunities. I truly admire the dedication of those young artists and their ability to overcome all these challenges. I strongly believe that objectives like music and art, crucial components of a well-balanced education that will enable Afghan youth to become tomorrow's agent of peace and change. Tonight is only one among thousands of untold successful stories occurring in Afghanistan. In 2001, only 800,000 children were going to school. Now, more than 8 million children are in school, and 40% of them are girls. In 2001, we only had 3,400 schools. Now we have more than 16,000 schools. The number of teachers increased from 20,000 in 2001 to 200,000 right now, with 60,000 are female teachers. Before, we had only 3 vocational and technical institutes. Today, we have 83 of them. There were only 3 functional universities in 2001. Now we have more than 82 universities across Afghanistan. We had only 1 college of teachers training in 2001. We have more than 43 teachers training colleges all across Afghanistan. We couldn't have achieved all this success without the support that we received from the United States of America. We are grateful for that. Looking ahead, our vision is to be a reliable partner to the United States in that part of the region, like Japan, South Korea, Turkey, and Germany. Afghanistan will be a partner with the United States to overcome all the challenges that we cherish together. As we conclude ANIM's tour in D.C., I would like to thank the State Department for their support. I would like to thank the Ministry of Education of Afghanistan and also the U.S. Embassy in Kabul, World Bank, and all other partners for supporting us to make this tour possible. And also, I would like to thank Kennedy Center for accommodating us this evening, and I hope that you will enjoy this great performance. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.